Let's explain the meanings of the orange warning lights one by one. Adaptive suspension dampers. Certain cars have sophisticated dampers in their suspension system, which can be set to be softer or firmer. If you see this warning sign, then the dampers will need checking. Air suspension. Plenty of posh cars come with air suspension system. The appeal is that they allow drivers to tailor the driving experience to an extent. This light can either indicate that you've left the air suspension in a raised setting or there's a glitch in the system. Airbag warning light. A number airbag warning light usually signals that the front passenger side airbag has been switched off by the driver, such as when installing a rear-facing child seat in the front chair. ABS. Anti-lock brakes are one of the greatest strides in making driving safer. They allow a driver to apply maximum braking and steer at the same time, such as when trying to avoid a pedestrian stepping out into the road. If the ABS warning light comes on, it means there is a malfunction with the system and drivers should have it investigated. AWD or 4WD. In cars that have selectable four-wheel drive system, this light appears once the driver has chosen to switch from 2 to 4-wheel drive operating mode, simply confirming their choice. Brake pad monitoring. Brake pads and discs wear out. This is your handy reminder to have them serviced. Broken bulb. Headlamp or brake lamp bulbs fail from time to time. This helpful warning symbol will act as a challenge. Do you try and replace the bulb yourself? Or pay a garage to put things right? Child safety lock. An increasing number of cars now offer an electronically controlled child safety lock for the back doors. It saves drivers from fiddling around with catches, and once the symbol is illuminated, it's simply confirming that the back doors can't be opened from inside of the car. Convertible roof. When this illuminates, it tells drivers of drop-top cars that an obstruction or more serious fault could be preventing the roof from opening or closing. Cruise control. There are various types of cruise control these days, with passive versions that maintain a set speed, active systems which vary a car's speed according to traffic conditions, and some that can even respond to changes in speed limits. The cruise control warning sign usually signifies that you've turned on the system. DPF, a diesel particulate filter, is an essential bit of kit that captures many of the nasty toxic particles that come from burning diesel fuel. The warning light can signal that the car's DPF needs to be cleaned out, a process which can involve taking the car on an extended high-speed run. Or there may be a more serious problem, which can cause cars to fail the MOT's emissions test. Electronic throttle control. It's dangerous to have a faulty accelerator. What if it stops sending a signal to the engine to accelerate? Or worse, it sends the wrong signal and causes unintended acceleration. So if this warning light comes on, have it investigated immediately. Engine management light. So much of a modern car is controlled by a computer, and the heart of such control systems is the engine management system. If the warning light comes on, the car will still function, but could possibly switch into what's known as a limp home mode, with a reduced performance. Have it checked out pronto. It could indicate problems with the emissions control systems. ESP, your car's electronic stability program, is what keeps it securely planted on the road. It's an important bit of kit, but sometimes drivers may turn it off. The warning symbol serves as a reminder, but if you haven't switched it off and the light comes on, there is a faulty which requires further checks. Glow plug light. Glow plugs help start a diesel engine when it's cold. So if you drive a diesel-powered car, you should wait for the glow plug symbol to switch off before starting the engine. However, if they come on after this, it means one of the glow plugs have a problem, common as they wear out over time. Key not detected. Many cars no longer need a key in the traditional sense. Instead, they use a smart key, which is meant to be more convenient. If you unlocked your car and started it, then popped back into your house, accidentally leaving your smart key on the kitchen table when you did, this is your helpful reminder not to drive off without the key. Lane keep assist. Some cars have lane keep assist to help steer themselves back into the lane of a road if they detect that the vehicle is wandering too close to a white road marking or verge. This symbol indicates that the system is active. A red symbol means the system is faulty. Low fuel level. Every driver is likely to have seen this at least once. It means the car's fuel tank is nearly empty, and if you don't put more fuel in, you'll be grinding to a halt fairly soon, usually somewhere between 20 and 50 miles. Rain and light sensor. Automatic lights and windscreen wipers are becoming increasingly common on new cars. If this warning light appears, it's telling you there is a problem with one of them. Rear fog lights. Been driving in fog and forgotten to turn off your car's rear fog lights? That's what this symbol is there for, reminding drivers to switch off fog lights. Rear windscreen heater. This is an easy one. It means the car's rear windscreen heater is on. Switch it off once you can see clearly out of the back. Traction control. When you see an orange symbol of a car leaving skid marks on the road, it can mean one of three things. If it flashes briefly, it's simply telling the driver that the traction control system is doing its job and preventing wheel spin. If you have chosen to switch off the traction control, the light will remain on as a reminder that the system is inactive. But if it has turned it on of its own accord, there is a problem with the traction control system which will need checking out. Tire pressure monitor. Most modern cars come with a system that keeps a watchful eye over the air pressure in the tires. If it detects that one has fallen noticeably compared with the others, it will warn the driver. If you are on the road, head for a petrol station and check the pressure and adjust accordingly. If you are unsure on how to reset the tire pressure monitor, the vehicle handbook will offer a step-by-step guide. Warning light. The yellow triangle with an exclamation mark will typically be accompanied by a message explaining what's gone wrong. Hopefully it will be self-explanatory, such as a low reservoir for the windscreen washer system. Orange or yellow warning lights on dashboard in a car. What do they mean? First of all, I'd like to say that there is no difference between orange and yellow. Some cars have yellow and others orange color, but it's the same. It always means that something is not working correctly. Orange or yellow dashboard lights remind you that something needs to be serviced soon, like an oil change or that something is wrong with your emission system. While not an emergency, you should have a repair person look at the problem as soon as possible. Alright,